Demons and Angels, Part 14. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yahushua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana. Should you require any of the books that I've written, or the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, please contact Pastor Rika, my wife, 0722-367-124, which is on a WhatsApp, international code +27, or go to my website, https://, which is Yaha, yahvah.co.za. This is the first time that you are participating in our study, Demons and Angels. I urge you to go to part one because you have missed quite a bit of information. Welcome to the study. You must also, it's very important to subscribe to the channel and so that you can be notified. It's free of charge, so you can be notified about all the other studies we are currently busy. Share this with your link with your family and your friends, and let's be a witness unto the glory of Yahushua, that's Jesus Christ, Yahushua. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof. Hannes. Now we're just going to continue where we left off yesterday morning. And we saw yesterday morning that it was referring to the titles in the Masoretic text reading to the ministers in Daniel. Ministers. For these passages are obviously nothing but a bold development of Deuteronomy 32 verse 8 and 9. Deuteronomy 32 verse 8 and 9. You know what? Sometimes my tongue just knots and I just can't get it out the knot, eh? You must also understand that English is my second language and not my first language. I always say to the guys, if you think I sound bad, come and preach in Afrikaans, then I'll listen to you. Deuteronomy 32 verse 8 and 9. Their doctrine is that the fate of nations are determined by combats among the terrestrial ministers. The combats among the terrestrial ministers to whom they have been assigned, and that despite Deuteronomy 32 verse 9, Israel also had a minister, which is Michael, who is assisted by another angel, Gabriel. They are not ministers. They are not ministers. They are head angels. They are the top of the lock of angels. They're not ministers. They're much more than ministers. They are messengers, top messengers of Yahweh. In Job, the divine beings appear before Yahweh as a body. Listen, the divine beings, now we're back at divine beings, appear before Yahweh as a body, perhaps to report to the performance of their task and to obtain their fresh orders. Now, are they humans or are they spirits, glorified spirits? Yeah, there's no flesh and blood in heaven. There's no flesh and blood in heaven. Because the Bible says flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of Yahweh. 1 Corinthians 15. We need to be changed from mortal to immortality. Be changed into a heavenly body. From an earthly body into a heavenly body. That's when the parousia is going to happen. In Greek, it is the coming of Yahushua. So now the idea has been created. Divine beings appeared before Yahweh, which is, they say, God or Yahweh, as a body. Perhaps to report, perhaps, not certain, eh? You see, when people start with things like perhaps and maybe, can be, it's like the aliens. They perhaps might be, it's possible, it can be. You understand what I'm saying? When anybody starts with perhaps or maybe, it can be, it's possible, I'm not even interested in listening to it. Because it's speculation, it's not a fact. And when we read the Bible, and when we study the Bible, we need to use facts. And that's why we have thousands upon thousands of different Christian denominations in the world. Because everybody says perhaps, maybe it's possible. And everyone starts his own little thing because perhaps it's going to work and perhaps I'm going to make a lot of money. And perhaps, because to 99% of these evangelists and whoever, it's only about the money. Perhaps to report on the performance of the task and to obtain fresh orders. Jaffa doesn't need a divine being assembly to come together. If he wants to give an order, he will just speak it. He will just think it and they will know it. One of them is Satan. So Satan is called a divine being. No, he can't be a divine being. His name is Satan. He's a fallen angel. He's not even called Lucifer here in Job. He's called Satan, a demonic spirit, a fallen angel. That's why he is. But according to this references here, when it talks about when the divine beings appear before God as a body, perhaps to report on the performance of the task and to attain fresh orders. One of them is the Satan. So he's also there to get the new orders. No, he does not have the right to go back into heaven. He's locked out with one third of the angels of heaven. They cast down on the earth. This is their domain. They can't enter into heaven. He does not have a free entrance. Once he's cast it out, he's cast it out. He says, one of them is Satan who carried out his functions under God's directions. Job 1 verse 6 and Job 2 verse 1. Shall angels seen by Jacob's ascending and descending the ladder. Genesis 28:12. Seem to be messengers going forth on their several errands and coming back to heaven to report. The angels. That's angels. It is only a vision that Job had, that Jacob had. It's not a fact. He saw a vision of angels going up and down the ladder, a ladder. It's terminology. It's terminology. He's using figurative speech. There's no ladder going from the earth into heaven. It's like seeing a vision and describing the vision. How can we take a vision where they say perhaps, maybe, it's possible, and then suddenly it became theology? And this is the problem. When most of the people in the churches outside, they take a certain word or a certain passage in a scripture, in a verse, and they make it theology. And that becomes dogma. The angels seen by Jacob's ascending. Ascending and descending the ladder. Genesis 28:12. Seems to be messengers going forth. It seems. It's possible. It might. It can. You see what I'm talking about? Perhaps. The speculation, going forth on their several errands and coming back to heaven to report. So and so on the ladder was Satan also, going up the ladder. Now halfway up somebody pulled the ladder out, so he had a nice fall, eh? He was kicked out of heaven, man. He was kicked out, he was humiliated. You must understand the terminology that is used. And the translations that happen with the scriptures over the last 3,000-4,000 years. You understand that? And the reviews. The problem is the reviews. Today is this and tomorrow is that. And the next thing, the things that is a maybe or is possible, the next thing is a fact. For the next generation, it becomes a fact. All right, I just want to use this again. Right, so we have the angels seen by Jacob ascending and descending the ladder. Genesis 28 verse 12. Seems to be messengers going forth on their several arrayed. So they're up and down the ladder. One ladder. So they're up in heaven. One angel is up. How do they get across each other? Someone fly around and then the other. No, it doesn't make sense. And they say, two ladders. No, maybe there's four ladders. Or they say, you see where you're going now? Now the whole heaven and to earth is a lot of ladders. Guys climbing up and coming down. And that's why the Satan took a chance to get one of the ladders. Yeah, we can also say it's possible that one of the angels put a ladder out. And so Satan had a great fall. You know the story of Humpty Dumpty? Humpty Dumpty had a great fall, right? It says all the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty back again. I remember that from my junior years when I was in school. You see, we must talk about facts. We can't say it's possible, it may be, it can be. That is what the confusion, this is where the confusion is created. And that's where the internet is playing a role to assist this unscriptural dogma, which is maybe can possible, suddenly becomes a fact. And people start to believe the lie. We're living in the time of the lie. It's the time of enlightenment, but not of the truth as much, but of lies. People choose to believe lies. And then I read in Romans that the Bible says, in Romans, that Yahweh says, I've sent them the delusion of the lie so they can believe it and die in their sins. They didn't want to know anything about the revelation names. I've sent them the delusion of the lies so they can believe it and they can die in their sins. That's something to be accused of. He says the narrative books often many instances of an angel, rarely two or more, delivering a message of performing in action or both. The angels appear in human form, always. Always, always, always. Angels won't appear in your little puppy, dog. No. And never in the form of a woman or a lady. Always in the form of a man. Always, always, always. The angel's opinion in human form and sometimes is not immediately recognized as an angel. That's why in the time of Lot, with Abram, when the Yahweh sent the two angels, Sodom and Gomorrah, they thought they were, which was a homosexual setup, and they wanted the two men. And Lot says, my two virgin daughters, you can have them. We don't, no, we don't want virgin daughters, we want those two men. You see, they were men. Always men, men. The appearance of an angel to Hagar, Genesis 6 verse 7, and Genesis 21 verse 17, and to Abram at Mount Moriah, Genesis 22 verse 11, was noted above. I'm just going to give the scriptures again. The appearance of an angel to Hagar, Genesis 16 verse 7, also Genesis 21 verse 17, and to Abram at Mount Moriah, which is Genesis 22 verse 11, was noted above. So they were men. He says, further, three men visited Abram. Further, three men visited Abram to announce the birth of Isaac. Two of them go on to Sodom to warn Lot to flee and to destroy the city. Genesis 18 verse 1. Genesis 18 verse 1. Genesis 19 verse 1. Genesis 19 verse 1. And Genesis 19 verse 13. Genesis 19 verse 13. So there's three. So we see them. The one went to Abram to warn him, well, to announce the birth of Isaac. And the other two went to Sodom and Gomorrah to warn Lot and his family to flee from Sodom and Gomorrah. The angel of Yahweh appeared to Jacob in a dream. The angel of Yahweh. Why didn't the previous scriptures in Genesis 18 verse 1, Genesis 19 verse 1, said there was three angels of Yahweh who came to Abram and to Sodom and Gomorrah? Because Yahweh, our Elohim, only had one angel. And that angel became his son. Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 to 14. Go study it. Make a study of that. And later on, I'm going to make a study with you. We will work through different scriptures. And there you must have some seatbelts, but you will definitely going to fall out of your chair. And I don't want you to get hurt. The angel of Yahweh appeared unto Jacob in a dream, saying, I am Yahweh of Bethel. Bethel. Now, I say, I am. Now, it's reads in the 6:11. Let's read it. I am the God of Bethel. Now, the word El is also a title to Yahweh. El, Elohim, Eloha. Are all titles. They just come up. So, I am God of Bethel, and verse him returned to his home. Genesis 31 verse 11. Genesis 31 verse 11. The angel of Yahweh played a role not entirely clear in the event of the Sea of Reeds. Exodus 14 verse 19. Exodus 14 verse 19. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to stop here because I want to go back to point 4 tomorrow morning, just for starters. Otherwise, Maranatha, Yahweh is coming back again. Hallelujah.